Morning, everyone. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so as to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, for the glory of your name and the salvation of souls, bestow on the priest St. Lawrence of Brindisi a spirit of counsel and fortitude. Grant, we pray, that in the same spirit we may know what must be done, and through his intercession bring it to completion. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Which is between Elam and Sinai, on the 15th day of the second month after their departure from the land of Egypt. Here in the desert, the whole assembly of the children of Israel grumbled against Moses and Aaron. The children of Israel said to them, "Would that we had died at the Lord's hand in the land of Egypt, as we sat by our flesh pots and ate our fill of bread? But you had to lead us into this desert to make the whole community die of famine." Then the Lord said to Moses, "I will now rain down bread from heaven for you. Each day the people are to go out and gather their daily portion. Thus will I test them to see whether they follow my instructions or not. On the sixth day, however, when they prepare what they bring in, let it be twice as much as they gather on the other days." Then Moses said to Aaron, "Tell the whole congregation of the children of Israel, present yourselves before the Lord, for he has heard your grumbling." When Aaron announces to the whole assembly of the children of Israel, they turn toward the desert, and lo, the glory of the Lord appeared in the cloud. The Lord spoke to Moses and said, "I have heard the grumbling of the children of Israel. Tell them, in the evening twilight you shall eat flesh, and in the morning you shall have your fill of bread, so that you may know that I, the Lord, am your God. In the evening quail came up and covered the camp. In the morning a dew lay all about the camp. And when the dew evaporated, there on the surface of the desert were fine flakes like hoarfrost on the ground. On seeing it, the children of Israel asked one another, 'What is this?' For they did not know what it was. But Moses told them, 'This is the bread which the Lord has given you to eat.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
By demanding the food they craved. Yes, they spoke against God, saying, "Can God spread a table in the desert?"
The Lord gave them bread from heaven.
Yet he commanded the skies above, and the doors of the heaven he opened. He rained manna upon them for food, and gave them heavenly bread.
The Lord gave them bread from heaven. Such large crowds gathered around him that he got into a boat and sat down, and the whole crowd stood along the shore. And he spoke to them at length in parables, saying, "A sower went out to sow, and as he sowed, some seed fell on the path, and birds came and ate it up. Some fell on rocky ground where it had little soil. It sprang up at once because the soil was not deep, and when the sun rose, it was scorched, and it withered for lack of roots. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it. But some seed fell on rich soil and produced fruit 100 or 60 or 30-fold. Whoever has ears ought to hear." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
That beautiful seed of faith and how it is received. That beautiful word of God, the very voice and message of God. That word is very efficacious. It's more than just a word written on pages. It's the very voice of God penetrating our life, coming into our ears and our mind and our heart. And it's written not necessarily on the pages of Scripture, but written right on our flesh and bones. It penetrates bone and marrow, as St. Paul says, and affects us so deeply. To receive it and to have a proper place for it to dwell. You know, sometimes, unfortunately, it falls on a path that birds eat it up, as the Lord said. In other words, sometimes that happens to us, and he's speaking about all of us. You know, it's just there, but it's not taking root. And if it does take root, it's not deeply rooted. And when it sprouts up, the sun scorches it and it dies. But it's really planted deeply and it's cared for. It really produces 100 or 60 or 30-fold. It just can't be God's doing that, but us to receive it. Can't be just God speaking, but when he does speak, where does that word fall, or that seed of his word fall? And how is it received and cultivated and really grows within us to produce 100, 60, or 30-fold? How beautiful it is for us to gather for Holy Mass, to hear and receive the word, and to allow it to find a place in us. And then by prayer and God's grace and our cooperation with that grace, it grows. In every situation of our life, we know how to respond to that word. Because there's certain situations that happen each day, right? And the Lord is speaking, that word is conversing with us in our mind and our heart. It forms our conscience. And it makes us follow him with the right decision. But if it doesn't fall properly and is cultivated and finds a home within us, then it dies off. In other words, we have to have a cooperation with God's work. He's not just going to do this,
without us cooperating with him. We'll run the race and fight the good fight, but like the runners in the race, God is handing onto us the baton. Are we able to reach out our hand and accept it? Or do we just want him to run the race for us? And us just to stand there and perhaps cheer for the winnings? It's part of the journey. It's part of the race. But that prize of everlasting life is given to us if we just cooperate with God's grace. Just a little note on the first reading from the book of Exodus. I'm sure you understand that what a beautiful kind of reading of the foretaste of the Eucharist, the manna coming down from heaven, that whole gift from God, the bread from heaven coming down, and it is sprouted forth through the dew that evaporated on the earth. Nice foretaste of a nice vision of what the Eucharist is for us. So men ate the bread that came down from heaven, that manna, but they died. Jesus says the one who eats this bread that comes down from heaven will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And the dew of the Holy Spirit comes upon the elements of bread and wine and, of course, allows them to spring forth for us in the words of Christ's consecration. And it becomes part of us, that is him. He and you and I are joined together as one. But this bread, when we eat it, it will gain for us eternal life. I like how the Old Testament comes into fruition and the New Testament of Christ's fulfillment of that. And how you and I are to receive it, to really cultivate it in our life. So even the Eucharist that Christ feeds us, he extends his hand, and you and I receive it into our own bodies. So we always cooperate with God's grace. And then what we do and how we take this Eucharist, that it will produce 160 and 30-fold for us. Because it's not just in the reception of communion, but it's also how that communion transforms us and finds a worthy place for us. So we're constantly being converted to him. That it just doesn't find a place in us that has no roots, that doesn't have deep faith. It doesn't find a place in us that is just there for sentimentality or some kind of other reason than to allow Christ to grow within us. It's all part of conversion. Part of that journey. And when that happens, what a beautiful abundance of the fruit of the Eucharist, which grows into our life for eternal life. Just lastly, please, if you would permit me, I want to say a little bit about Lawrence of Brindisi. Today we celebrate his optional memorial, right? He was a Franciscan, a military person, an exegete, which means that he studied studied scripture, and he was also the superior general of the community, or the general minister, as the Franciscans called it. He was a powerful homilist, and he told it like it was. I guess being from the military, he didn't mix words, right? He shot from the hip. And he just was powerful in that. As he gave them the word, and he allowed that word to be rich in the soil of his preaching, and as it was planted in the hearts and minds of the listeners. He's also declared a doctor of the church, which means that he has brains to sell, which means that he has a very nice understanding of sacred scripture. And having that understanding, he allows it to come and take root in people who are ready to receive it. Lawrence of Brindisi is an example for all of us in our own vocation to allow this rich word, this seed, to be planted in our hearts, in the hearts and minds of other people, by our participating in handing on the baton, so to speak, to the next generation, but first to be convinced ourselves. Once we are convinced, how beautiful is that sharing and passing on as we give Christ to one another and at the same time being fed by Him from the bread of heaven. After reflecting on God's holy word, let us now place these petitions before the Lord with confidence and trust.
To the church on her journey of faith, may God's word guide and nourish her. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Leaders of nations and communities, called to shepherd God's people, may the Spirit of the Lord lead them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who hunger and those who produce the harvest, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God bless our gathering this day to be fed in word and sacrament. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the faithful departed, especially Gary Margaretson, called home at the end of their faith journey, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick and suffering, Ralph Speakman, Laura St. Manette, Carolyn Stenger, and all those on our prayer list, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the intentions of Peggy Henson, for which this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We also pray for the spiritual and temporal needs of St. Mary's Parish, so that all of us may further the mission of Jesus, like St. Lawrence of Brindisi did. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us also pray for an increase in vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, especially from members of our own parish family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, we place these petitions before you. If they are in accord with your holy will, we ask that you grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacrifice which we gladly present on the feast of Blessed Lawrence of Brindisi be pleasing to you, O God, for taught by you we too give ourselves entirely to you in praise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Lawrence of Brindisi, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise as without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the new fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to your help us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, Lamb of God,
who take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Blessed is the servant whom the Lord finds watching when he comes. Amen, I say to you, he will put that servant in charge of all his property.
The body.